Welcome back, everyone, to another Let's Play for Endless Ocean. Now, if I remember correctly, last time we were going to Blue Hole, which should be right behind me. It would make sense that the Blue Hole is where the hole is. Do I just need to swim down? Maybe. Yep, just need to swim down. Music? Why do you sound ominous? For lack of a better description? Hey, listen, I just remembered something. There's supposed to be some kind of precious objects here. At least, that's what Thorman said in his email. Why don't we try looking for it? Okay. Sound good, Tang? There's a lot of Tangs around here. The thimble of Mele Patau. There's something there. I noticed that, cat. Let's get closer and check it out. Get near the seafloor, wall, or other object, and press plus to enter the zoom mode. You can then examine the area in more detail. Okay. Hey, look at that! This is how to find small fish or items that you might otherwise miss. Try interacting with what's here. What are you? Three-spot Daskulas. To grab and acquire an object, point at it and press B while holding down A. You got the dolphin medal. Something's gonna happen. Looks like you found a rare object. Hey, it's that dolphin again. You remember that prankster dolphin from the coral forest? Yes I do. A little hard to forget him. Oh, look at him. He's curious about you. Why don't you try interacting with him? Come on, take a chance. Welp, that didn't go well. He vanished. I think you scared him away. Yeah, I think so too. I think he's heading toward the lagoon. Why don't you head back to the Gabbiano? Then we can follow him. I mean, if you want. Clown tricker fish? Tiger fish? Is that even what it is? I was right the first time, actually. Woohoo! Clown trigger fish. I always get them wrong. Nothing there. No? Since we are here, we might as well do a little bit more exploring. Nothing to see here, really, out of the ordinary that I can tell so far. Absolutely nothing going on. Nope. Not a thing. Come on. There we are. My guess, Stark's dinosaur. Poor we're gonna see them a lot in the future. Okay, is there like anything around here? Ah, there is something. The Shell of Memories. I'm pretty sure that's a random find, so yeah, yes. We're already finding stuff to find. And a striated frogfish? Striated? I don't know how to pronounce the first one. Is that the way we came from? No, that is not the way we came from. So there should be stuff this way. Should be. Anything interesting around here? No? Okay. Anything on the walls? Not that I'm finding over there. In my experience with this game, while there's a chance that you'll find something just randomly on a wall or somewhere, I think you're a lot more likely to find them around areas such as these reefs and such. And sometimes it's kind of obvious because, as we saw with the lagoon, there were those really tiny yellow fish around somewhere. There's something this way that I'm gonna like. I happen to really like sharks, so if we happen to find sharks, I will be ecstatic. Speak of the devil, cloudy cat sharks. I am very happy that we found them. I mean, they're just so small. Is there anything else around here, though? I feel like there should be. Aha! Oh. I know how to lure you two out. A yellow watchman goby. And I'll wait for him to come back up. Randall's pistol strip. I'd like to know who named some of these things in the first place. There's a lot of cloudy cat sharks here, actually. I wonder if it's a breeding ground. I mean, it's possible. Up and over this way, because I want to say that there's a type of ray around here somewhere. I'm a little surprised that we haven't found it yet. There should be a ray around here somewhere. To go back to the Gabbiano, because we can reach the lagoon. Doesn't look like we have to go back to the Gabbiano, so we're gonna reach the lagoon. What are you? Samurai squirrel fish! Like I said, I want to know who named some of these things, because some of these are just really interesting names. Alright, let's see. Heading back this way. Okay, we're at the lagoon. Oh, that dolphin! I think he's stuck in the lagoon. Dolphins use a kind of sonar called echolocation to navigate. It works like a radar dish, sending out signals and then getting them back. But shallow water like this can cause them problems. They have trouble figuring out where they are. And in the worst case scenario, they can become stranded. Now I'm worried. Poor little guy. We have to help him. Okay, cat. After I do a little bit of zooming around here. Please don't be a green chromos. Hey, it's not a green chromos. That's a goby. Green mandarin goby. As you just clip through several branches of coral. Very pretty, though. I know there's more places I can look at around here. Where are you all? Okay. There's something this way? There it is. Red-spotted Blenny, and the green chromos. We'll see them a lot too. Please don't be another green chromos. Those are Stark's dim oisles. They're very common in the zoom spots. Something over here. Oh, hey! I think this is a red goby? Five-lined coral goby. It is red, but it's not the name of the goby. I hear you. Oh, so teardrops do exist here. They were just hiding last time. Got it. Another mandarin goby. We're going to attempt. Alright. I think that's everything around there. I'm gonna help out this guy. Hey, I think he's following you. Let's lead him to the coral forest. I was not facing this way a few seconds ago. Okay. You did it! He escaped the lagoon. I think that dolphin likes you. I'm not surprised, not after how you helped him out. You can just dive at your leisure now. Come back to the Gabbiano when you get tired. Alright. I'll probably do some editing. So that way you don't have to see me just traversing the map, unless something interesting happens. But that will happen when it happens for editing purposes. I wonder, was there anything over here? Oh, there was something over here. What's over here? another goby. A red-spotted goby. That likes to also clip through the frickin' coral. Got it! That's good enough for west. Now I'll head south for a bit. Anything over here? Said something about the Towers of Power. Shimmering. Does that mean that they have a zoom spot? Yeah, 17 hours and I don't know where things are still. Found any zoom spots on those towers yet. I think that should be enough of covering the map for now. So we'll return to the boat and then figure out what the next steps are. I missed one square. Okay. I'll have to catch that square later. Yep, nighttime. Welcome back. That was pretty amazing, by the way. Why, thank you, Cat. I've never seen a wild dolphin act so friendly. Not even toward me. You don't interact with the water, Cat. How is this a surprise? Yep, bird. Huh? Oh, never mind. Anyway, the people of Pelago love dolphins. Long ago, they thought they were holy messengers of a sort. Oh, there went. Aww. They trust you now, so make sure you're nice. I couldn't work with someone who didn't respect animal life. Oh yeah, here, take this. You can now use the underwater whistle. It's an underwater whistle. What, you've never seen one before? You can use it to communicate with marine animals. Yeah, these are all the rage with the hip young marine biologist crowd. Oh hey, another bird. The cool thing is that it sounds the same above or below water. Try using it to signal dolphins. You want to give it a try? Partner interaction, use the stern to access. Oh, it went away again! Use the stern to access a training point where you can interact with your partner. If you find stuff in the ocean, I'll put it in your footlocker. That way you can find everything in one convenient place. If we learn anything about the items, you can check that too. We donate most finds to the local museum. They love us there. Yay, we can now use the footlocker. This is where we store items that we find underwater. Okay. This guy drives me nuts every time, but how are we hearing that dinky little phone all the way out here? Call a partner. Hey, a common bottlenose. It actually worked. I thought for sure it was bogus. Great, why don't you give your partner a name? Oh, wait, let me give you some name ideas. I'm good at this. Webby. What do you think? Don't like it? Well then, what kind of name did you have in mind? S... 2... U-E-A-K-E-R. Squeak for short. This was recommended by a good friend of mine that goes by the name Terry. Oh hey, that's really good. But while you're at it, how about teaching your partner a trick? Oh boy. Point to your partner's mouth or fin and press A. Release it, then press it again while moving the Wii remote in A direction. This will give him a command. Try giving your partner directions. Once your partner learns your hand sign, release A and then shake the controller to give the go sign. Your partner will perform each time you give a sign. Try giving the go sign. Sing! That's not bad, actually, for the first time ever doing this. Wow, that's really good! Oh wait, he's trying to say something. That all you got, pal? Yes. Hey, don't look at me. I'm just a translator. Hey, kinda fun, right? Directing your partner like this can be a great experience. The more you practice, the closer you two will get. If you do well, your partner's tricks will evolve and change. But that's really up to you, so keep training. I won't do too much of that on screen. I have good news. Thorman sent the night diving equipment I've been bugging him about. It's actually just a light, not very complicated at all. Why did that take so long to get that? I don't know what took him so long. Okay, so Cat's on the same page as us for once. That's good. Anyway, I soak it on your buoyancy compensator. You can now go night diving. That will happen in the next episode. There are lots of different fish that are active at night. It's really cool down there. Or so I've heard. We'll finish up with whatever's on the deck, and then we will do night diving in the next episode. Southern Rock Pepper? And then, description name Adele? Adelaide? Nope, Gentoo. Gonna be any other birds joining us? No. Doesn't seem like. I hear a bird. Where the heck is that bird? I heard it. Okay, no bird. I will see people. next time. Until then.